No?
I'll
get the advent candle in. No?
Thank you.
Would you like to sit down? Welcome. It's lovely to see the church. I know this is very unusual and perhaps difficult here, but it is lovely to see the candlelit church with as many as we can here to celebrate the beginning of Christmas with this carol service. And I'm David, if you don't know, I'm the rector. Thank you for coming along. We think of those who aren't able to be out, and we welcome you. There's an order of service, and I should say this evening we're live streaming the service. So to those who are at home watching, hello as well. At home you have a bit of an advantage, actually, because you have an order of service. It is on the website, but you've got the sight of it. At home you can sing vigorously, and we expect to hear complaints from the neighbours. Sadly, I'm afraid in church there's no carol singing. You can hum along to some of the congregational carols, but I'm sorry, I must ask you not to sing, and we, unless you're exempt, to keep your face masks on. Again, just to remind you to keep distance, particularly as you leave the building, and just there are hand sanitizers on your way out. The other safety notice is that you've got a candle. So just be careful. It would be awful to survive coronavirus and then immolate yourself in the public accident in the carol service. The irony would be unbearable. As I say, there are still sort of bits to join in. So when it does come to sort of the prayers, and I will ask you to stand a couple of things at the end, I hope you'll feel that some sort of participation, because worship should be past participation. It's not something that we want. Just going to wait for people to take their seats, and then we're going to, as I say, we'll listen to our choir sing, who are permitted to sing, and they're going to sing the carol S. Islanderus in Sprung. And we're very thankful to the choir, the musicians, organist, director of music. It's been a very difficult time for musicians nationally. Because of these restrictions. So it's lovely that they're able to do what they've done. They've worked very hard, and it's not always been easy. So thank you very much in advance to them. Thank you.
Thank you.
Beloved in Christ, be it this Christmas time our care and delight to hear again the message of the angels. And in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which has come to pass, and the babe lying in a manger. Therefore let us meet, read, and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God, from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace on earth and goodwill among all his people, for unity and brotherhood within the church he came to build, and especially in this parish of Welwyn and Welwyn Team. And because this of all things would rejoice his heart, let us remember in his name the poor and helpless, the whole, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick and them that mourn, the lonely and the unknown, the aged and the little children, all those who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have breathed his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater night, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in the Lord Jesus we are forever one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven in the words which Christ himself hath taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Almighty God, bless us with his grace. Christ, give us the joys of everlasting life, and unto the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of angels bring us forth. Amen. Amen.
Isaiah, prophecy of the Messiah's birth. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shone. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Glory, 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 glory Thank you. visit the Holy Family. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favours." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger.
Thank you. The Magi are led by a star to Jesus. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is shepherd to my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. Whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Oh,
fill you with the sweetness of inward peace and goodwill. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.